Hello everyone, welcome to another Adobe Illustrator tutorial. My name is Andre from Dagubi. In this tutorial I'm going to show you how to design this banner. First of all, create a new document, go to File and click New. I use 340 mm for the width and 210 mm for the high, and I use color mode RGB. So the first thing what we need is a big rectangle, so please choose rectangle tool and create a rectangle like this. Change the color, go to the swatches panel and choose for the fill brown color. And for the stroke, dark brown color. And change the stroke width, set this to 4 points. So that's fine. Next, choose the polygon tool and click on your artboard. So we need a polygon with 3 sides. And I try 20 mm. So next, change the color, none color for stroke, and for the fill we need the same dark brown color as for the stroke. You can drag this stroke color into the fill color and set the stroke color to none. So next, scale this shape and now choose the free transform tool and move this into the rectangle and rotate this shape. Hold down the shift key to 90 degrees. So move this rectangle, choose the direct selection tool and move this in the center of this stroke. So it's very important to enable the smart guides. Go to view and make sure that the smart guides are enabled. So next, make a copy of this shape, hold down the Alt key and drag this shape and hold down the Shift key for vertical align. So next you have to use the blend tool. Choose the blend tool and now click on this shape and on the second shape and go to Object, Blend and choose Blend Options. Change the spacing to specified steps and set this steps to 7. Enable the preview 7 or 6. So 6 is okay. So next, you have to choose the Add Anchor Point tool and you have to add a new anchor point on this vertical line. This is the line for my blend effect. Go to the center of this line and add a new point. And now choose the direct selection tool, select this point and move this point to the right. So if you wish, you can change this corner to smooth. So click on this little dot and drag this. So that's fine. And now you have to make a copy of this shapes with this blend tool. So open the layers panel and make a copy of this blend. Drag this layer down to the new layers button. Select this new copy and now open the transform panel. Go to the transform panel options and click flip horizontal. And move this to the left so you can hold down the shift key and you can use the arrow keys to move this in very big steps. So next, choose the direct selection tool and now click on this anchor point and hold down the shift key for the horizontal align and move this to the center of the vertical stroke. So that's fine. Next, you have to make a copy of this rectangle. So drag this rectangle down to the new layers button. And now it's very important to make these steps. So I'm going to create a clipping mask. So move this new rectangle on top, on first place and inside this group. And now deselect all, go to select and click deselect. Choose the parent layer and click on this button, make release clipping mask. So next I'm going to change the stroke width of my rectangle. Set this to 5 points or 6. Okay, next I move all the shapes in the middle. So select all and choose a selection tool. Make sure that Align to Artboard is checked. And now click on these two buttons, Horizontal Align Center and Vertical Align Center. So, but before you do that, it's very important to group this blend layers. So make undo and undo. So the legs, the blend layers and group this. Go to object and click group. And now again, select all. So please select this by clicking on the little circle by the group layer. And now again, choose the selection tool and click on these two buttons. So next I'd like to scale the blend tool a little bit. So select this group and scale this. So hold down the Alt key and you can scale this proportionately. That's fine. So you want to scale the banner slightly wider. So choose the direct selection tool and select only the left side. And now you can use shift key and the arrow keys on your keyboard. And don't forget to move all shapes in the middle, select all and choose this button, Horizontal Align Center. So the next thing what we need to do is create a copy of the whole group. So drag this group down to the new layers button and select the new group and move this group up. So next, choose the direct selection tool and select only the right side of this banner and move the selected anchor points to the left. And we need a new copy. Select the new copy and move this copy up and a little bit to the left. So next, open the new group and you have to delete the left side of this blend group. So next, choose the direct selection tool and select only the left side of this banner and move the points to the right. So zoom in and now select only the rectangle and choose the add anchor point tool, and you have to add a new point on the left side. Go to the center of this path and add a new point. So next, choose the direct selection tool, select this new point and move this point to the right. So you see this little mistake. So this is because the clipping mask. So you have to change the stroke, select this rectangle and open the stroke panel and change the stroke, the align stroke, to inside. And you have to change the stroke width, so set this to 4 points, 4 or 5 points, and make the same with the other rectangles. So you can choose the group selection tool and select this rectangle, change the align stroke to align stroke to inside, and change the stroke width to 4 points, and the same with the big rectangle. So that's fine, and choose again the direct selection tool, and I'm going to move this little bit more to the right. So next, select the group of the small shape and move this shape down behind all other groups and move the whole group down and a little bit to the left. Like this. So next you have to select the both smaller shapes with the selection tool. So, but this time do this inside the layers panel, select both layers and now go to layers panel options and choose collect a new layer. And now I'm going to create a copy of this new group, but before I do that, select the whole group and choose the direct selection tool and move the whole group down. So next, make a copy, drag this down to the new layers button and select the new copy. Go to the transform panel and flip horizontal and flip vertical and move this new shape down. So next you have to move both shapes. So first move this shape down, hold down the shift key and press the arrow keys up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And make the same with this shape. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, before I start to draw the backside of the banner, you have to expand all the shapes. So first, select all, go to select and click all. And first you have to expand the blend tool. Go to objects, blend and choose expand. So next, choose the group selection tool and start with the smaller shapes. Select this shape. And now go to object, expand appearance and open the pathfinder and click on this button, merge, and make the same with all the other groups. Select the other group, expand appearance and merge. So next, choose a pen tool and I start inside this group. So zoom in and now go to this corner and click on this anchor point, create a new shape. So choose the direct selection tool and move this point a little bit up. And now you have to apply a brown color for a stroke color, the same brown color. Change the stroke align stroke to inside and set stroke wide to 4 points. And now it's important to arrange your groups. That's fine. And you have to change the fill color. Make this fill color a little bit darker. So next, I continue inside this group and make the same. Choose a pen tool and create a new shape. Go to this corner and this corner. Now change the line stroke to inside and move this point a little bit down and drag this layer behind the big layer, behind this rectangle. So next you have to create a new layer and move this layer down behind all the other layers. And now choose again the pen tool and start by this anchor point. sorry, you have to move this new shape into the new layer. That's fine. And change the align stroke to inside. And make again a new shape. So if the pass does not close, you have to join these two points. So choose the join tool and draw a circle above these two points. And now select the new shape and change the line stroke to inside. So next I'm going to change the color, fill color of this new shapes. Select all shapes and change the color, make the fill color a little bit darker. So that's fine. And I'm going to group all these layers. Select all and now go to Layers panel options and choose collect a new layer. So the next thing what we need to do is create a new layer for my background and move this layer behind the banner. So, and please lock the banner, zoom out and create a big rectangle. Choose rectangle tool and create a big rectangle. Change the color, none for stroke, and for the fill I'm going to use a gradient. So I use this basic orange yellow gradient and change the angle to 90 or minus 90. So change the yellow color to blue and the next gradient slider change this to white. So I'm going to delete one of the sliders and that goes like this. Click on the slider and drag the slider down. Oh, sorry. And change this gradient slider . Make a double click on the gradient slider to change the color. So that's fine. So next I'm going to create a new shape. So this time choose the polygon tool and click on your artboard. And we need three sides and change radius to 100. So first scale this new shape. Choose the free transform tool. So that's fine. And change the color. Change the color to white. Only the fill color. And now you have to create a pattern brush. So open the brushes panel and click on this button, new brush, or you can go to the brushes panel options and click new brush. Choose pattern brush. Okay. Change the colorization method to tints and click OK. So you can delete this shape and now create a big circle. Choose the ellipse tool and create a big circle. Hold down the shift key for a perfect circle. And now choose the selection tool. Enable align to artboard and click on these two buttons, horizontal align center and vertical align center. And apply your new pattern brush. Change the color none for fill and white color for stroke. So scale shape a little bit, circle. So if you wish, you can change the stroke color to more yellow, for example. You can change the opacity. And if you wish, you can change the blending mode to overlay. So that's fine. And next, you have to create a new shape. Choose the ellipse tool and create a circle, a small circle like this. Change the color, fill color to black, and create a new brush. Click on this button, new brush, and this time choose scatter brush. And first change this for the size to random and the other three to random. And change the colorization method to tints. Click OK. So delete the circle. And now choose the paintbrush tool and draw a line. So now you have to modify the brush. Make a double click on this brush and change this a little bit. That's okay. So delete this line and now change the color to white, the stroke color to white, and draw some you can change the stroke white. So select all these new lines and change the opacity and change the blending mode, set it to overlay. So if you wish, you can select some of these lines and change the color, for example, to yellow. And the other lines to more blue. So that's fine. And create a new circle. Choose again the ellipse tool and create a big circle. Change the color, none color for stroke, and for the fill color, I use the same color as the background. So choose the eyedropper tool and click on this rectangle to get the same color as a rectangle. Next, go to the gradient and change the type to radial. So please click on this button, reverse gradient. And now delete the blue gradient slider. Click on this slider and drag this down. And move this slider to the left. Now open the transparency panel and set the blending mode to overlay. So what you have to reverse the gradient again. So that's better. And you have to change the opacity of the right slider. Change the opacity to 0. So that's fine. And now make some copies and scale some of these new copies. So hold down the Alt key to make a copy. Scale a little bit. Make a new copy. So, and last, you have to create a clipping mask to hide the circles outside the artboard. So choose the rectangle tool and create a new rectangle. So select a new rectangle, and it's very important to move this rectangle on top. So this is on top. That's right. And now select the group layer and click on this button, make release clipping mask. So if you wish, you can draw some splatter, some color splatters. So I use my own brushes for it. So all these brushes are available on my website togobi.com, and I use this brushes set. So I change the stroke color to orange, choose the paintbrush tool. Oh, sorry, the stroke color to orange. It's fine. So last, I'm going to create a new layer over all the other shapes, and you have to create a clipping mask, create a big rectangle, next deselect all, and click on this button, make release clipping mask. Choose the paintbrush tool and create some new splatters. So I choose white color. or yellow color. You can change the transparency. And I'm going to create a shadow for my banner. So that goes like this. Make a copy of the whole group. Select the banner and now go to Pathfinder and click on Unite and move this new shape a little bit to the right and a little bit down. Change the fill color to gray. Oh, sorry, the fill color. And change the blending mode to multiply. That's it, I'm finished. Thanks for watching. If you like this tutorial, please press thumbs up and share it with your friends. If you want to see more of my tutorials, please subscribe my channel. Hope to see you soon.